愿神的恩惠平安与我们在座的同在。
And may the grace and peace of God be with us.
算一算哈，大概我有三个安息日没有在这边呢。
And if I counted, I haven't been here for about 3 Sabbaths.
第一个安息日刚好跟教会的弟兄姐妹去游船呐，到了地中海沿岸呐。
And the first Sabbath, I was cruising in the Mediterranean with some brothers and sisters.
那在第一个安息日呢，刚好下了船啊，大家都忙着，所以那个安息日只有各住祷告。
And so that Sabbath day, everyone was busy disembarking from the ship. So we all had to pray by ourselves.
那第二个安息日呢，我们刚好游玩、欣赏、观赏了这个以弗所。
And the second Sabbath, we were at the city of Ephesus, and we just finished a tour.
所以在那个安息日啊，我就用这个主题啊，谈了大概二十分钟啊，做聚会。
So that day, I used this topic for our short service about 20 minutes.
因为教会那些年轻的姐妹啊，向船公司了来，借用了一个聚会啊会议的这个场所。
And the younger sisters in our group has asked the cruise line to let us borrow a small meeting room.
所以就在船上跟同龄在这边讲道。
And so, on the ship, we had a brief service.
那后段就来谈谈传道在工作生涯的一些见闻。
And then later on, we had a testimony where I shared my experience of preaching.
然后第三个安息日呢，刚好大家都下船去走路，走得很远。
And the third Sabbath, we disembarked from the ship again, and we walked a long distance.
那回到船上呢，都已经暗了。
And when we
很晚了，还天黑。
When we got back on board, it was already dark.
所以第三个安息日也只有各住祷告。
So the third Sabbath, we all prayed individually.
大概三个安息日是这样过的。
So that's how we spent our 3 Sabbath days.
那今天呢，我就继续来谈这个致以弗所教会的一封信。
And today, I would like to share with you the topic, A Letter to the Church of Ephesus.
这一段是有关于启示录的第二章里头的一些的经文的记载。
And this is recorded in the book of Revelation, chapter 2.
我们先来看一下启示录的第二章。
Let's turn to the book of Revelation, chapter 2.
启示录的第二章，我们从第一节来看起。
Let's start reading from verse 1.
二章的第一节，你要写信给以弗所教会的使者，说，那右手拿着七星，在七个金灯台中间行走的说，二节，我知道你们的行为，劳碌忍耐，也知道你不能容忍恶人，你也尝试验那自称为使徒却不是使徒的，看出他们是假的来。三节，你也能忍耐，曾为我的名劳苦，并不乏倦。四节，然而有一件事我要责备你，就是你把起初的爱心离弃了。五节，所以应当回想你是从哪里堕落的，并要悔改，行起初所行的事。你若不悔改，我就临到你那里，把你们的灯台从原处挪去。阿们。刚才我们所看的就是主耶稣在拔摩海岛向主耶稣的爱徒老约翰所启示的一段话。
And so here, the five verses that we have read are the revelations that God has shown to the beloved disciple of the Lord Jesus, John.
也就是告诉约翰啊，说你要写信啊，给以弗所教会啊。
And God said to John, "You must write a letter to the church of Ephesus."
其实，当时主耶稣他心中挂虑的就是以弗所教会堕落的原因呐。
And our Lord Jesus was worried about the falling of the church in Ephesus.
希望能够借着这封信来唤起以弗所教会的这种 爱主的心啊。
And hopefully through this letter that he can arouse the church, the members to find their love.
主耶稣要约翰来写这封信。
And our Lord Jesus wanted John to write this letter.
我们可以看出主他内心充满的无限的爱。
And we can see that there was boundless love in our Lord.
甚至里头也有带着责备的话。
And in this letter, he rebuked them.
所以希望透过主的爱徒约翰把这个意思写出去，寄出去。
And hopefully through the beloved disciple of John, that he can show his message, or rather he can relay his message to the members.
刚才我有看过哈，这个里头有称赞的部分，也有责备的部分。
We see here that there were praises and compliments to the Ephesian church as well as rebukes.
主耶稣虽然没有在现场，但是主耶稣他看得很清楚。
Even though our Lord Jesus was not there personally, but he witnessed everything.
主要原因因为他是真神。
And the reason being that Lord Jesus is our true God.
所以他知道以弗所教会有劳碌的那种辛苦。
And he understood the hard labor of the Ephesian church.
也有那种忍耐的付出。
He also understood that they have bear much patience.
甚至更能够分辨那种假师傅的那种啊那种啊啊那个要领办法。
And they were even they have even found ways to test those who are false.
然后在里头呢，我们也看到主耶稣很不客气的来责备以弗所教会。
Yeah, we see that our Lord Jesus rebuked the Ephesian church sternly.
希望以弗所教会失落的信心，失落的爱心，能够再重新找回来。
And he wanted the church of Ephesus to once again find the love that they have lost.
我想主耶稣要他的门徒约翰来写这封信的重点。
And I believe that the main reason why our Lord Jesus wanted John to write this letter
应该要教会再找回失落的爱心。
It is to have the church regain its lost love.
我们首先来认识一下以弗所教会的人文地理那个整个环境。
Let's take a look at the geographical background the historical background of the church in Ephesus.
以弗所教会比较靠近地中海岸。
The church in Ephesus is close to the coast of the Mediterranean.
当时往内延伸还有几个教会。
And if we were to go inland, there were several other churches.
那几个教会呢？大概50公里甚至有70公里，也有80公里，那个距离那么远。
And the distance of among these churches were about 50 to 70 kilometers.
然后成为环状形的布置，散布在这个以弗所教会的周边。
And they were all encircling the church of Ephesus.
然后呢？
To their left.
然后呢？那个时候，以弗所等于是说那个整个亚细亚教会的一个联络的中心点。
And the church in Ephesus happened to be the coordination center for all the churches in Asia Minor.
甚至也可以说是整个亚细亚教会的最大间的一个教会。
We can say that it is the biggest church in Asia Minor.
以地点来说呢，这个是最富庶的一个地方。
Geographically speaking, it is a pretty well-off city.
可以说是非常繁华了。
It's a very prosperous.
也可以被称为当时罗马帝国的四个大都会、大城市的一之一啦。
And we can say that it is one of the four metropolitans of the Roman Empire.
也可以称为说亚细亚的市中心啦，政商中心啦。
And we can say that it is the commercial center of Asia Minor.
结果后来也因着它的周边有一条河叫做基斯特河。
And there was a river by its side.
结果这个河就淤泥淤沙太多了，过高了。
And due to accumulation of sand flowing through this river.
所以河水就泛滥了。
The river overflowed.
所以就把整个以弗所就全部淹没。
And the city of Ephesus was flooded.
那不只是淹没，包括整个城市建筑全部把它掩盖起来。
So it's not, and this flood covers all the buildings in the city.
因为淤沙太严重了。
And due to the accumulation of sand.
然后呢，也把那个出海口、那个海港全部都阻塞了。
And this accumulation of sand also blocked the harbor or the port.
原本它可以那个船啊可以靠岸。
Initially, ships were able to moor by the harbor or the port.
啊，结果哈、哦、那个因为淤泥淤沙太多，所以船啊就无法靠岸了。
And due to accumulation of the sand, these ships were no longer able to moor close to the coast.
包括现在那个以弗所那个港口都。不能用了，所以移到另外一个地方去了。
Even till today, the port in Ephesus is no longer usable,、oh, and it has been moved to another place.
这先来认识一下它的环境哈。
So this is to give you a geographical background on the city of Ephesus.
再来谈谈它的政治环境啊。
Next is its geopolitical circumstances.
当时的罗马帝国啊，是把以弗所看为是一个自由的城市。
During the days of the Roman Empire, Ephesus was deemed to be a free city.
也可以说呢，等于是以弗所有它的城市的自己法律及规定。
That is to say that the city of Ephesus is self-governed.
给他们这个啊，亚细亚省啊，给那个以弗所他们自己去治理。
So the province of Asia Minor and the city of Ephesus, they govern themselves.
甚至给他们办理那个运动会啊。
And they even have sports games.
他们以前常常喜欢办那个哦那个运动会赛跑啊。
And they usually have distant races.
所以当时亚细亚的省长啊啊就任了啊这个就任的这个罗马总督啊。
When the governor of the province of Asia Minor came to his position,
就选择在以弗所这边。就等于是就把那个以弗所当成为当时啊那个就任的一个总督府了。
And he the governor set his residence in the city of Ephesus.
甚至有时候他们政府啊都会按时轮流在以弗所这里来做一种哦审判啊审问啊重大的案件。
And so major crimes or major judge cases were judged in the city of Ephesus.
那再来谈到那个他们的人民呢、
啊、？Next，
人民他们的居民呢、啊、
？Talks about next regarding the residents of the city。
他们的居民有保有他们的土著。
And there are natives to the cities。
啊，甚至有包括一些从雅典啊、哦、移民过来的后裔。
There were even some immigrants from the city of Athens.
甚至也有他们原本属于希腊人的后裔。
And there were also descendants of the Greeks in the city.
也有另一部分是犹太人啊，移民过来这边居住的后裔。
There were also a small portion of Jews residing in the city.
所以以弗所也等于是说多种的啊民族啊。
So we can say that the city of Ephesus is multicultural.
然后再来提到有关以弗所的宗教。
Next is religions in the city.
保罗传福音来到以弗所。
When Paul came to the city of Ephesus,
应该被称为是早已的圣灵所建设的教会。
The church he established was the church established by the early rain.
神的教会有早已跟晚已所建设的教会。
And the churches of God is established by the early rain or the latter rain.
所以以弗所是属于早已的教会。
The Church of Ephesus belongs to one established by the early rain.
那要注意哦，真耶稣教会是属于晚已建设的教会。
Please note that our True Jesus Church is one that is established by the latter rain.
都同样有附带这种来护卫神国的重要的使命啊。
We all have the mission to defend and to guard the truth.
那以弗所呢？它的一切的建筑。可以把它看为是 很大的奇观之一啊。
The architectural of the city is a wonder.
尤其在里头有一所很著名的庙啊。
And there was a very famous temple in the city.
也就是亚迪米神庙。
It is the temple of Athena.
也就是崇拜哈、哦、这个啊这个女神了、啊、哈、哦。
And it is she is a goddess.
啊，所以。那个时候哈、哦、他那个庙、啊、很兴盛啊。
And her church, her temple was flourishing.
所以圣经里头《使徒行传》十九章里头也有记载有关于这个亚底神的 这个庙宇的建造。
And the construction of this temple was mentioned in the book of Acts chapter 19.
我们看一下《使徒行传》十九章。
Let's turn to the book of Acts chapter 19.
使徒行传十九章。
The book of Acts chapter 19.
十九章，我们来看二十四节。
Let's read verse 24.
二十四节开始是描述到有一个打银匠的师傅，名叫的迪米丢了。
And here there was a silversmith by the name of Demetrius.
这个迪米丢他是在制造亚迪米神龛的人呐。
And he is a workman who works on the shrine of Diana.
这个人呢，有很好的手艺啊。
And he is very good with his craft.
生意不错。
It has good business.
所以这个人呢，在这边就一直在奉承着这个亚迪米女神呐。
So he was worshiping the goddess Diana.
然后呢，这个保罗他们传福音来到这边呢。
So Paul came to the city to preach the gospel.
所传的福音就跟他做生意有冲突啊。
And his message contradicts his business.
因为保罗他们传福音说这个偶像都要除掉啊。
Because Paul said that all these idols must be removed.
哇，这样子那个迪米丢这个专门制造神龛的这个师傅如果这样来的，我都没工作了。
So to Demetrius, if that is the case, then he would lose his business because he mainly does silver shrines for Diana.
所以那个时候就纠缠的保罗这些一行人了。
So he went after Paul and his group.
那个时候闹得轰轰雨雨啊。
And it has caused much chaos in the city.
所以整个城市呢，真的闹得很大。
And it was great news in that city.
所以圣经这个《使徒行传》里头也描述到说，当时这些门徒也为了一方面要躲避，不跟他们正面冲突，就躲到戏院里面去了。
And so Paul and his group, to avoid Demetrius, they hid in a theater.
所以可见他们对这个偶像的祭拜是这样的轰行轰盛啊。
So you can see that the worship of idols, was prevalent in the city.
根据一些历史的记载，
According to historical records,
该城的人认为说这个亚迪米女神是非常灵验的一个神很灵验
So, the people of the city felt that Diana is one who grants wishes.
所以如果有路过从地中海沿岸经过要到罗马的，一定会在以弗所这边下船。
So those who wanted to go to Rome through the Mediterranean, they would always disembark in Ephesus.
然后去祭拜这个亚迪米女神。
They would go and worship in the temple of Diana.
所以拜神明完了以后，他们就感觉有平安了。
And after they have worshipped Diana, they felt that they have found peace.
所以这个就是他们的偶像的一种祭拜方式。
So that is how they were religiously in those days.
那根据一些历史的记载。
According to historical records,
当时虽然他们很迷信这种异教的风气很盛
So even though the worship of idols was prevalent,
甚至有人犯了罪逃到这种神庙里面就可以获得的护庇。
And criminals, if they managed to escape and hide in the temple of these idols, the temple would give them protection.
甚至描述到你主要到这个女神庙里面这个女神的那个祭司你跟她接近甚至跟她行礼你就可以得平安
And even if you go to these temples and perform sexual acts with the priests of this temple, you will find peace.
我想大概因为这个缘故吧，所以难怪这个香火祭拜这么鼎盛。
I think that is one of the reasons why the temple was so famous.
所以保罗他们传福音来到这边
And Paul came to the city.
真的非常的难传
And they found it was difficult to preach the message of God there.
但是当时以弗所教会的弟兄姐妹仍然也本着从神领受的那种那种信心去开拓这个福音的工作。
Yet Paul and his team, with their faith in God, they still went ahead evangelize in the city.
所以当时保罗他们传福音来到这边呢。
So when Paul came to the city of Ephesus,
保罗也曾经在这边跟他们相处了三年之久。
Paul stayed in the city with the locals for 3 years.
我们看一下《使徒行传》20章。
Let's turn to the book of Acts chapter 20.
使徒行传二十章三十一节。
The book of Acts chapter 20, verse 31.
三十一节。
Verse 31.
所以你们应当警醒，纪念我三年之久，昼夜不住的流泪，劝诫你们个人。这一段就是保罗他对以弗所教会的勉励的话。
So here are the words of encouragement that Paul delivered to the people in Ephesus.
也可以说是惜别的感言啊。
We can also say that it is his farewell speech.
这个提摩太啊，也曾经受到保罗所嘱咐，来到这里来传福音啊。
And Timothy was entrusted by Paul to come to the city to preach.
这是根据提摩太前书的一章三节里头所描述啊。
This is recorded in 1 Timothy chapter 1 verse 3.
那个时候也有百基拉，甚至亚基拉、亚波罗他们都曾经有出现在这里啊。
And even Aquila, Priscilla, and Apollos also went to Ephesus.
因为保罗他要做这个福音的开拓的工作。
And because Paul was responsible for preaching and evangelizing,
也等于是说他来以弗所教会时间很短暂。
And his stay in the Ephesian church was short.
所以保罗要离别之前，也就邀请了当地就是亚细亚教会当地的一些长老来牧养亚细亚的教会。
And so Paul requested the elders in the Asia Minor churches. To pastor the sheep in Asia Minor.
这是有关于这个福音传到亚细亚之后的一些情形。
So these are some of the things that happened after the gospel was preached to Asia Minor.
那主耶稣透过约翰提到有关于一些赞美的话。
And our Lord Jesus through John praised the church in Ephesus.
也就是在启示录的二章二节这边提到说劳碌啦、忍耐啦这些问题。
So it is recorded in Revelation chapter 2 verse 2. It mentions their works, their labor, their patience.
这个有关于劳碌或者忍耐，不是付出在保罗门徒的身上。
And this labor and patience was not performed by Paul and his team.
这是属于劳碌的这方面呢，是应该是在宣道这方面的付出啊。
And labor refers to the evangelism in the city of Ephesus.
我们可以来参考提撒罗尼迦前书啊。
Let's turn to First Thessalonians.
提撒罗尼迦前书的二章啊。
Chapter 2.
提撒罗尼迦前书的二章，我们来看第九节。
First Thessalonians chapter 2 verse 9.
第九节
Verse 9,
弟兄们，你们纪念我们的辛苦劳碌，昼夜做工，传神的福音给你们，免得叫你们一人受累。这边保罗就向帖撒罗尼迦前书，帖撒罗尼迦教会来做一些勉励的话。
So here Paul was encouraging the members in the church in Thessalonica.
其实保罗他的工作都没有连累到当地的信徒。
In fact, the work of Paul has never caused any problems for the local church.
都是属于那种宣道、福音、传福音的工作付出。
His work was mainly to evangelize the gospel.
当然，这种劳碌必须要有忍耐啊。
And of course, when you labor, you have to toil.
这是做神的工必须要有付出忍耐的这种心智啊。
And when you labor and toil, you should have patience.
如果你有参加教会的福音工作的时候，你就知道。
If you took part in the gospel group, you would understand this.
你要不断的关心慕道朋友。
You have to show your love and concern for the truth seekers.
你要不断的来引导慕道朋友。
You have to continue to guide the truth seekers.
你要不断地来向慕道朋友讲解有关福音的重要。
And you have to continuously encourage or relate to the truth seekers regarding the importance of the gospel.
一直鼓励到他受洗。
And to keep on encouraging them until they are baptized.
受洗还不够，还要注意关心他未来的信仰的成长。
And just receiving baptism is not enough. You still have to be concerned about their future faith.
这个都是属于那种宣道工作的一种所付出的辛苦。
And so these are all the labor that we have to be put in evangelizing.
所以这个是一种劳碌，一种忍耐。
So this is one kind of labor and one kind of patience.
再来，我来谈到有关以所教会不能容忍恶人啊。
And next, the church in Ephesus cannot tolerate evil.
甚至要来试验使徒的真假。
And they even tested the apostles.
使徒真假真的有时候很难分辨。
It is indeed very difficult to discern a genuine and a false apostle.
当然，你如果跟着他接触久了，大概就可以分辨出来。
And of course, if you have been with that person long enough, you'll be able to discern the two.
如果你只有见一面的话，你就很难以分辨。
However, if you only met that person once, then it's very difficult for you to discern.
那如果你跟他深谈的话，你就可以分辨出来。
Yet if you have deep conversation with that person, you should be able to discern.
所以过去以弗所教会当时就是有这些假先知的这些恶人。
So in those days, there were false teachers and prophets in Ephesus.
而且这个假使徒这个掺杂在里头，真的让以弗所教会很难以去分辨出来。
And these false disciples have caused much problem for the church.
所以呢，只有要试验了。
And it's only through tests.
主耶稣在传福音的时候也曾经说过。
When our Lord Jesus was ministering, he once said,
要防备披着羊皮的假先知啊。
You have to be aware of prophets who put on the skins of the sheep.
这是主耶稣在传福音的时候曾经有讲过的话。
You have to be careful of false teachers who are wolves in sheep's skins.
那保罗呢，对以弗所教会所招过来的这些牧养的这些长老啊。
So when Paul asked all these elders to come to him,
也有一种很情自然以离别的这种言语啊。
He also used words that showed his emotion that he was very reluctant to leave them.
所以他在离别之前也特别提醒有凶暴的豺狼会进入你们当中。
And that is why prior to his departure, he reminded them that there would be wild beasts among them.
所以啊，他们这种豺狼啊是不爱惜羊群的。
And these wild beasts will have no love for the sheep of God.
要特别注意啊。
Therefore, they should watch out for them.
我们看一下《使徒行传》的二十章。
Let's turn to the book of Acts, chapter 20.
二十章的二十九节。
Chapter 20, verse 29.
这是当初保罗在以弗所要离别之前对他们长老所勉励的话。
So these are the words that Paul encouraged the elders just prior to his departure.
我们从二十七节看起。
Let's start reading from verse 27.
二十章二十七节。
Acts chapter 20, verse 27.
因为神的旨意，我并没有一样违背，不传给你们的。二十八节。
28.
圣灵令你们做全群的监督，你们就当为自己谨慎，也要为全群谨慎，牧养神的教会，就是他用自己血所买来的。二十九节。
29.
我知道我去之后，必有凶暴的豺狼进入你们中间，不爱惜羊群。我们先看到这边。这里保罗就提醒说，当这些豺狼进入你们当中，就不会爱惜羊群。
It says here in verse 29, Paul said, "These savage wolves, when they come in, they will not spare the flock."
这个可以被称为是魔鬼了。
We can call them the devil.
但是呢，对保罗来说，他有那种疑心不忍呐、
啊。And to Paul, he had pity on the flock.
所以他就很谨慎、很仔细来叮咛这些长老。
And that is why he carefully, reminded these elders.
当我离开的时候，会有豺狼，冲进来。
That after my departure, savage wolves would come in.
即使我不在，你们也要向神祷告，要保护这些羊群。
And even if I'm not here, you have to pray to God to protect His flock.
所以保罗这一番提醒的话
，So these are reminders from Paul.
真的非常重要
，Very important.
那也因着保罗对他们的提醒
，And because of these reminders.
可是到后来，我看这些长老大概就没办法来防备这种豺狼冲进来的危机啊。
And I think that these elders later on were not able to stop these savage wolves from coming in.
因为这些豺狼很凶暴啊。
Because these wolves were indeed savages.
因为我们来继续看29节。
Let's continue to read verse 29.
说我知道我去之后，必有凶暴的豺狼进入你们中间，不爱惜羊群。三十节。
30.
就是你们中间也必有人起来说悖谬的话，要引诱门徒跟从他们。所以你们应当警醒，纪念我三年之久，昼夜不住的流泪，劝诫你们个人。
31.
所以从这些保罗所提醒的话
，So from what Paul had reminded the elders，
真的到后来被保罗说中了。
Indeed, what Paul said came true.
因为这些豺狼冲进来，真的把神的羊一个一个吃掉了。
Because these savages came into the church and began to devour the sheep one by one.
所以就没办法继续维持这种神的教会啊。
And therefore, the church of God was no longer sustained.
所以到最后呢，神就用大水把整个以弗所整个淹盖了。
And therefore, with a flood, God has flooded the city of Ephesus.
我大概看了看了那个整个以弗所面积有几十公里的这么广大的范围啊。
The area of Ephesus is over tens of square kilometers.
他们的建筑物也非常的雄伟。
And the architecture was grand.
目前可以看出挖出来的，被泥沙盖住了，挖出来的这些建筑物真的很雄伟。
From what has been excavated so far, we can see that the architecture in the city was indeed very grand.
地面铺的都是大理石。
And the ground was covered with marbles.
只是因为破坏了所以有一个洞，有一个洞啊。
And due to destructions, there were holes in them.
所以这些豺狼冲进来，就把主的羊全部把它消灭了。
So these wolves, when they come in, they began to devour the sheep of God.
年轻的时候，约翰他曾经写过一番提醒的话。
While he was young, John actually wrote some reminders.
所以记载在约翰一书的第四章啊。
This is recorded in 1 John chapter 4.
一节到三节里头啊。
Verse 1-3.
这是约翰他提醒的话。
These are reminders from John.
他说世上有许多假先知已经出来了。
He said there are a lot of false prophets that have already gone out into the world.
总要试验那些灵出是不是出于神的。
That you have to test whether the spirits comes from God.
所以这个就是我们在末世的时候也要特别注意的地方。
These are also the things that we have to pay attention to in the end days.
以前有，现在还有。
It happened in the past. It will happen again.
所以真的，我们要特别提醒自己。
And that is why it is a special reminder to ourselves.
甚至保罗他在书信当中写给帖撒罗尼教会的信
So when in the letter that Paul wrote to the Thessalonian church,
不要消灭圣灵的感动
，do not quench the fire of the Holy Spirit，
更不要藐视先知的讲论
，and do not despise the words of the prophets，
总要来查验善，要持守
，that you have to examine the goodness and to maintain them，
各样的恶要禁止不做
，and you have to abstain from all evils。
所以从这些来看真的让我们了解到过去有现在 撒旦更恶劣。
So from what we have seen so far, what happened in the past, Satan will use the same tactics again now in the future as well.
我们刚才有看过保罗有交代啊，这些长老啊。要过来关心牧养以弗所亚细亚的 这边的教会。
Earlier we have mentioned that Paul had reminded the elders in Asia Minor to pastor the flock in Ephesus as well as in Asia Minor.
根据以弗所教会在地中海沿岸的地理是非常重要。
We see that the geographical location of Ephesus was very important in the Mediterranean area.
我们现代人常常听过一句话说了
，There is a saying，
条条道路啊通罗马
，That all roads lead to Rome。
没有错，有一条海路就是地中海沿岸。
It is true that there is a route by the sea, and that is by the coast of Mediterranean。
地中海沿岸必须要靠以弗所。
And the coast of Mediterranean, you have to rely on Ephesus。
刚才我大概有稍微提过它的地理位置跟政治环境。
We have mentioned earlier the geographical location of Ephesus and its political situation.
所以以弗所在当时的地理位置很重要。
So the geographical location of Ephesus was vital in those days.
所以以弗所教会就很容易受到有心的人士来给他骚扰、给他扰乱。
And therefore, a lot of people would like to.Conquer the city of Ephesus.
其中一部分是高级犹太人的律法。
And one of the group was actually the Jews.
甚至有另一部分的人指着自由晃荡的那个主义来骚扰。
And there were also another group that hold on to the ideal of freedom and liberty.
甚至有些不做正经事业啊，单靠着信徒施舍来救济他们。
And there were also some people who were poor and would not like to work and relied on the alms of the church members.
所以以弗所呢，他要扮演着很重要的角色。
So Ephesus plays a very important role.
如果没有真理的根基，说真的，很容易被打倒。
And without the foundation of the truth, then it's very easy to be shaken.
所以难怪主耶稣对约翰在拔摩海岛特别给他启示。
And that is why our Lord Jesus specially revealed to John on the Patmos Island.
所以责备的话就是说，要把起初的爱心，把离弃的爱心，把它找回来。
That the church in Ephesus must find the loss that it had initially.
大概我把它整理了。
And I have compiled this.
会离弃起初的爱心，大概有内在跟外在的原因了。
And there are probably internal and external reasons why the church in Ephesus had lost its initial love.
内在的原因就是指着我们个人呐。
The internal reason referring to individually the members.
保罗他们传福音来到以弗所，大概时间只有短短几年而已。
And Paul came to Ephesus to preach the gospel for some few years.
以弗所教会的成立不是保罗他去开拓去建设的。
And the finding of the church in Ephesus was not done by Paul.
之前几年有门徒在这边开拓。
There were some disciples who had started the pioneering work in the city.
而成立了以弗所教会。
And that is how they found the church of Ephesus.
这是几年没有历史的考究就不知道。
And how long for that period? We don't know. There was no historical record.
只有记载保罗在这边跟他们牧会三年。
The only record that we can find was that Paul was in Ephesus pastoring the church for 3 years.
保罗在那牧会三年，说真的，这是才是真理的造就那个根基的栽培。
And those 3 years were the time that Paul spent to form the foundation of the members in Ephesus.
其实这种时间很短，太短了。
And actually, 3 years is a very short time.
因为没有一个很根深蒂固的真理的基础建设，说真的，很容易去动摇。
And without a firm foundation that is deeply rooted in the truth, then the faith of the members can be easily shaken.
就很容易受到异端邪教的左右了。
And the members could easily be influenced by the other religions.
这是个人内在的因素。
So that is the internal reason.
当个人内在因素道理真理上不足的时候，
when a person's faith in the Lord is not enough,
他 道理就开始动摇。
That the person's faith would have been shaken.
道理一动摇的话，就失去他内心的那个信仰的热忱。
So once the faith has been shaken, that the fervency for God has been lost.
就无法继续保持信仰纯正。
And that is why the person will not be able to maintain its purity of faith.
自然而然的就失去了对神、对弟兄姐妹的爱了。
And naturally, the person will have lost all love for brothers and sisters.
因为开始对神怀疑嘛。
Because that person begins to doubt God.
对道理怀疑嘛。
Begins to doubt.
对教义怀疑嘛。
And to doubt the truth.
就产生了动摇。
And therefore, that caused the shaking of his faith.
再来提到那个外在的原因了。
Next is the external reasons.
这个外在的原因就是当时罗马政权一直在压迫。
In those days, there was much persecution from the Roman government.
所压迫就是说你们要去崇拜偶像。
And the persecution was that the members must worship idols.
以后要拜那个太阳神了。
They have to worship the sun god.
甚至他们原本在那个以弗所周边的，就是有那个雅典米女神了。
And even as we mentioned earlier, they have to worship Diana.
所以这种崇拜女神的。是有很多人来奉承着呢。
And there are many worshippers of Diana in that city.
像刚才我讲的这个迪米丢，他是制造那个这个偶像的这个神龛的一个工作的人呢。
For example, the silversmith Demetrius that I mentioned earlier, he was one who made silver shrines of Diana.
他如果来信保罗所传的福音，那我都没工作了。
And if he had to come to believe in the gospel preached by Paul, then he would have lost his job.
So 就这样来跟保罗的传福音就抵触到底。
And that is why he was in conflict with Paul regarding his religion.
甚至有一个亚历山大。
There was even another man by the name of Alexander.
这个亚历山大也有很大的煽动性啊。
And Alexander was very great at causing trouble.
他就煽动说保罗所传的信仰啊，这个福音呢，跟正统的犹太人呢、犹太教不适合了，不吻合了，不一样啊。
He said that the message preached by Paul or the religion preached by Paul is different from the Jews or the religion of the Jews.
等于保罗所传的福音呢，根本就不是从原本犹太教传承下来的。
What he's saying is that the religion preached by Paul is not from the traditional religion of the Jews.
这个亚历山大就一直煽动说保罗他们这些。福音的这道理不能听的。
So Alexander was spreading false news that the messages preached by Paul cannot be accepted.
所以可见当时保罗他们传福音多么的艰难啊。
So you can see how difficult it was for Paul to preach the gospel.
最后我来谈了哈。
Finally, I would like to mention
这个信仰要坚持到底。
That we have to maintain our faith to the very end.
也就是说，信仰要有恒久性。
That is that our faith must be enduring.
要有几个重要的要素。
And there are several factors.
第一
，one
要有真理跟圣灵的根基。
That we must be deeply rooted in the truth.
我们来看提摩太前书。
Let's turn to First Timothy.
提摩太前书的第三章。
First Timothy chapter 3.
提摩太前书的第三章。
First Timothy chapter 3.
十五节。
Verse 15.
三章十五节。
Chapter 3, verse 15.
十五节。
15.
倘若我单人日久，你也可以知道在神的家中当怎样行。这个家就是永生神的教会，真理的柱石和根基。这一段圣经告诉我们说，这个家就是永生神的教会。
And here it tells us that the house of God is the church of the living God.
也就是神的家。
And this is the house of God.
这个神的家有真理的柱石。
And in the house of God, you will find a pillar of truth.
以柱石为根基。
And a ground of the truth.
所以这个神的家如果没有神的真理，没有圣灵的话。
In the house of God, if there is no truth of God and there is no Holy Spirit,
神的家是撑不住的。
Then the house of God would collapse.
所以今天我们要认清楚。
Therefore, today we have to come to an understanding.
我们所信仰的重点在于真理。
that our faith is based on the truth.
然后靠着神的圣灵，他来引导我们。
And rely on the Holy Spirit granted to us by God, that the Holy Spirit will guide us.
如果你的真理扎的根
，If you are not deeply rooted in the truth,
你就越稳，很稳，根基很稳。
If you are deeply rooted in the Holy Spirit, in the truth, then you will be firm.
不足的地方，圣灵在补助你。
And where you lack, the Holy Spirit will help you.
让你得到更丰富的力量。
So that you will receive abundance of strength.
所以要信靠真理，要来领受圣灵。
And that is why you have to believe in the truth and to receive the Holy Spirit.
第二个要素。
Second,
要有信心。
You must have faith.
这个信心就是要相信真理，要相信真神。
And the faith is that you must believe in the truth and believe in the true God.
更要相信你所领受的圣灵。
And to even believe, even more, believe in the Holy Spirit that you receive.
我们刚才有提到保罗传福音来到以弗所一带。
And earlier we mentioned that when Paul, on his missionary trip, came to Ephesus and its neighboring vicinities.
因为那个时候保罗来这边时间很有限。
As we mentioned, the Paul spent limited time there.
所以有一次跟他们讲到，讲的三更半夜。
And there was once he was preaching to them, and it came to midnight.
人很多。
There were still many people.
里头没位置坐。
And there was no room to sit.
结果有个年轻人叫做犹推古啊。
And there was a young man, Eutychus.
啊，这个犹推古就坐在这个窗户的旁边呐。
He was sitting on the window sill.
结果保罗偏偏一直讲了半夜。
And however, Paul kept on continuing with his sermon right into the midnight.
结果就犹推古呢就掉下去了。
And Eutychus fell asleep and fell out of the window.
大家都认为说犹推古死掉了。
Everybody thought that Eutychus would have died.
可是呢，保罗下去说没有，他的灵魂没有离开他的。
And Paul went downstairs, saw him, and said his spirit is still in him.
所以经过祷告一番呢，他就活过来了。
And after some prayers, Eutychus was alive again.
这件事情要见证信靠神的信心。
And this incident is to prove that you have to believe in God.
要给以弗所教会啊，能够一种激励的信心呢。
You must have faith in God, and it is to encourage the people of the members of Ephesus. To rely on God.
所以信心如果没有再用真理再后盾的话，这个信心很快就被推翻了。
If you have faith but you have no truth, then your faith would have been lost quite easily.
所以犹推古复活的这件事情本来有很大的信心的激励啊。
So Eutychus coming back to life is actually a good encouragement to the members.
可惜没有真理的后盾成为依靠。
However, their faith has not been rooted in the truth.
所以这件复活的事情也很快被淡忘了。
And therefore, this incident was soon forgotten.
所以没有真理，又没有圣灵，又没有信心。
If there is no truth and there is no faith,
当然很快会被消灭掉的啦。
And of course, one would have been taken away by the trends of the world easily.
那一消灭掉了，就失去了爱心了。
And once they have been taken away, they will have lost their love for the church.
所以因着他们失去的这种信靠神的心，当然就没有爱心了。
And so once they have lost their faith in God, they will no longer have faith. They will no longer have love.
那这份的爱心是包括什么呢？
And what does this love encompass?
爱神的心。
It encompasses the love for God.
爱人的心。
And the love of fellow human beings.
因为你的爱心不是只有爱人啊。
Because you not only love people,
更不是只有爱你周边的这些人啊。
And your love is not just for the people around you.
如果你的爱心只有爱你周边的这些人，太狭小了。
If your love is only for the people around you, then you have a very narrow love.
你这个爱心要爱大家。
You have to love everyone.
哦，不是说哦，我跟你很好，我就爱你就好。
It's not just that I am on good terms with you, I will love you. That's all.
这种爱心神不完全接纳的。
And that is that kind of love God will not accept completely.
所以这种爱心。包括你不认识的人，你就都爱他。
And your love should also encompass strangers.
当然，这是要有一个时间去缓冲自己，去接纳自己。
And of course, you'll need time to accept yourself first.
你要求自己才会做得到啊。
You have to require yourself to do this in order to actually carry out the act.
没有对自己要求，怎么做得出来？
If you do not request this of yourself, then how will you take the first step to actually perform it?
所以哦，你如果没有爱人，怎么会爱神？
So if you do not love your fellow human beings, how would you love God?
所以主耶稣在这边责备以弗所教会啊。
So here, our Lord Jesus rebuked the church in Ephesus.
也可以说，以弗所你已经失去原来初信的那种信仰的热忱了。
That Ephesus, you have already lost that initial fervency, for God.
你无法继续保存那种信仰的纯正了。
So how are you going to maintain the purity of your faith?
因而就失去了你起初爱弟兄的这种爱心了。
And for that reason, you have lost the initial love that you have for your fellow brothers and sisters.
所以呢，今天啊，主耶稣要约翰来写这封信。
And that is why today the Lord Jesus wanted John to write this letter.
要再次来唤醒以弗所教会。
To once again to wake up the church of Ephesus.
要把真正爱神爱人的心去发挥出来。
That they must once again to love God and to love the fellow human beings.
今天我们从主耶稣所讲的这些话。
And today, from the words spoken by our Lord,
我想主耶稣在我们的信仰，在我们的教会也应该看得出来，在我们的教会。
And I believe today in our church.
所说的我们的教会不是只有温哥华了哈。
And when I say our church, I'm not referring to just Vancouver church.
我所讲的是整个真主教会。
I'm referring to the entire True Jesus Church.
神都看到。
And God has seen all of us.
神看到，他也会来给我们做一种提醒。
And when God sees us, He would also remind us.
你是真的很辛苦，很忍耐哦，来爱我的教会。
Have you truly labored and have patience for my church?
还是失去爱人爱神的心
or that you have lost your love for your fellow brothers and sisters and lost your love for God.
我们的神在天上都在看
and our God and Father is actually watching us.
所以你有爱你自己吗
so do you love yourself?
你爱你自己，你也应该爱我们周边的人。
If you love yourself, then you should love the people around you.
爱周边的人就是包括这些比较少于见面的人，你要跟他打招呼。
And if you love the people around you, you should also be loving people that you have not meet very often. So you have to be proactive and greet them.
我有时候跟那个 Simon 哈，他们夫妻讲话哦，不大通了哈。不过在默契上都可以了哈。
And I have some problem communicating with Brother Simon and his wife, but overall we can still communicate quite well.
这是为什么
？Why is that？
因为我讲的话他。听得懂我的意思。
Because he understood the meaning of my words.
啊，他讲的话我也可以揣摩他的意思。
And I can also guess what he was saying.
为什么
？Why?
同龄里面的默契。
Because we have this common spirit.
所以我们在语言上不是问题。
So even though we may not speak the same language,
打开我们的心。
But when we open out our hearts,
去接纳我们所不认识的人。
We have accept people whom we don't know.
去爱我们的教会。
We have love our church.
去爱我们教会的弟兄姐妹。
To love the brothers and sisters in our church.
更爱那些慕道朋友。
And to love our truth seekers.
不然的话，神有一天会责备我们的。
Otherwise, one day God will rebuke us.
就像当初在责备以弗所教会一样。
The way that He rebuked the church in Ephesus.
愿神祝我们大家。
May God bless everyone.
早上我们就勉励。学习到这边。
And my servant ends here this morning.
来唱二十三首。
Let us sing hymn number 23.
我们只唱四节了哈。
Let's sing four stanzas.